I ask myself from time to time why people are so engaged with these animals. I know why I am as a paleontologist. But I think even people who are not paleontologists realize that humans have had a connection to animals like this for a long, long time. These animals were probably crucial to the survival, to the subsistence of early humans in North America.
I think people really love them because they closely resemble, you know, modern elephants, and especially because, you know, elephants today are so endangered and, you know, there's a lot of work to conserve them. Being able to look back in time and see their relatives, it just really opens your eyes to how important it is that we kind of conserve the world that we have around us and what we need to do for the future of our planet.
One of the special things about this display is that this is the only place in the world where you can go and see a mastodon associated directly with a mastodon trackway. We wanted to juxtapose the mounted skeleton with a cast of a set of mastodon footprints that we excavated not far from Ann Arbor, just down near Saline, at the Brennan mastodon site. So this is a really lifelike, careful juxtaposition of the animal and the trackway that it could have made.
There is a real tendency, I think, to think of museums as a place where everything has a neat label and is perfectly understood, put away in a drawer, almost for storage and safekeeping. But actually, many of the most exciting paleontological discoveries come from specimens that were already collected many decades ago, that were just sitting in museum drawers, waiting for someone to either have that technological advance or that moment of inspiration to put a couple of pieces together and come up with a new idea about the history of life on Earth.
One of the things that we wanted to improve about this mount is to give Owosso a new sternum. At the time the specimen was originally mounted, they didn't really know what that part of a mastodon looked like. Specimens hadn't been found. Now we do know. And so we were able to create, through 3D printing, a new sternum for this animal and revise the sort of front portion of her rib cage and chest.
Umorph is a versatile resource that allows us to gather and collect and share three-dimensional models of fossil specimens. So the way this works is we acquire these models through a process known as photogrammetry.
You take a lot of pictures of it from all different angles. You plug them into a program called Reality Capture. That program connects all the photos and kind of finds the overlap so you can create a 3D model.
If we have these virtual models, if we're missing one bone from, say, the right-hand side of that creature, we can mirror the left-hand bone if we have that in our collections and create a replica of that missing part, thus allowing both students and researchers to understand that creature as it would have appeared intact. These models are freely available to paleontological colleagues and indeed anyone out there in the wider public if they want to access or examine these materials. The future of digital paleontology is not restricted to the kinds of models of the outsides of fossils that we make and display on Umorph. There are also a variety of tools we can use to examine or dissect the fossils themselves, to look inside of those specimens.
We're beginning to do whole tusk CT scanning on the tusks of mammoths and mastodons. We can see the nature of the ecosystem that the animal was living in, the sorts of stresses the animal was facing. And it's evidence like this that is, in fact, helping us to understand now how important human hunting was in causing the extinction of these animals.
Now is a really exciting time to be a paleontologist. We're looking at old specimens in new ways. It's providing us with interesting insights that we wouldn't have had before this technology was available. And that's just the field as a whole. Here at Michigan, it's an exciting time simply because we're in this exciting new facility. There is this integration of research that usually goes on behind the scenes with the public face of paleontology through exhibits in the Museum of Natural History. We're actually making that archive, that story, that family album, if you will, of life's own history available to the wider public.